Elizabeth was a beautiful princess.
It was a typical day at Mabel's Fables, filled with dragons and princesses.
Can we see him flying away?
Kids and those young at heart whisked away into the world of Robert Munch.
I like princesses a lot, and I think it's nice to be like a princess.
Events like this one aren't new here, but today, many people are soaking it in as the bookstore approaches its final chapter.
I felt really sad. I honestly almost cried.
The bookstore that has been in Davisville since 1988 is facing a 70% rent hike. That, mixed with about a 20% drop in sales and never-ending LRT construction near Eglinton, is forcing them out.
Well, the first meeting, I went home feeling dreadful. I'm scared.
Eleanor LaFave opened this community institution 31 years ago. Upstairs, sprawled across the walls are signatures of famous authors like Margaret Atwood and some local up-and-comers.
This, to me, was a dream. I wanted desperately to write a book and be able to sign the wall, and 3 years ago, I had that opportunity.
It reads, a dream come true, which it was for Heather Camelot, who actually used to work at the bookstore and ended up bringing her kids here.
It feels really welcoming here. You know, there are a lot of nice people, and there's so many books.
I think it's going to be a tremendous loss for the parents who, for the new parents who are coming here. Mabel's, they have classes for little ones. They have classes for adults.
While LaFave isn't ready to turn the page on Mabel's Fables after receiving so much community support through calls and petitions, she also wants residents to know this issue doesn't just stop here.
It's about our whole city and all our main streets and keeping us all vital. And we don't want empty storefronts.
Huge deep breath and breathed out so much fire.
There has been a massive community response and push from local city councilor Josh Matlow to save Mabel's Fables. There's also a community meeting on Tuesday at Eglinton Junior Public School. In Davisville, Brandon Rowe, City News.